Hello students, welcome back to social study class. Before we begin the class, let us do little exercise. Follow me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now open and close eyes. Close your eyes. Open. Close your eyes. Open. Again. Close your eyes. Open. Close your eyes. Open. Very good. Students, what is this? Yes, this is our school magazine. Look at here. We can see different pictures. We also see different articles written by your teachers as well as your friends. What do other people can know from this school magazine? Yes, people can know lot about our school because when they read this magazine and see the different pictures given in the magazine, they will come to know the different activities and events that took place in the academic year 2019 and 20. So this is a source of information, and today we are going to study the topic sources of history. Now children, please open your SST book and go to page number 16. Our topic is sources of history. Millions of people have lived on this earth before us, and many things have happened. Like I was showing you our school magazine, where you could see many events took place in our school in the last academic year. So in human history, many things happened, and therefore human has a long history. And how do we come to know about this history? We come to know about this history from different sources. Look at the things lying on the table. What are these? Yes, these are coins. What are these? These are artifacts. Okay, now You will have a question, sir, what are artifacts? Artifacts are things made and used by earlier people, such as household goods like dishes, utensils, toys, jewelry, etc. Now look at here. You can see different monuments. First one is Colosseum in Rome. Second one is what? You know it very well. Yes, this is a picture of the Taj Mahal in Agra. Look at here. Can you recognize this picture? Surely some of you can recognize. This is the picture of Char Minar in Hyderabad. And look at here. How many of you have gone to Mumbai? Oh, many of you. Very good. Now can you tell me what is this picture? Yes, this is Gateway of India. It's a very famous picture. Lot of shootings takes place here. Now, this is a magazine. So, this is a written material. Now, what I showed you on the table, they are different sources, right? And from these sources, we can learn history of a particular time. And therefore, if historians have many sources, then they can tell us or give us the whole picture of a particular period in the history. And if they have few sources, then obviously they can give us some idea of a particular period in the history. Now, these sources are categorized, and we will see those categories. Look at the chart here. Sources of history. Sources of history divided into 1, 2, 3, 4 categories. First one is coins. Second one, artifacts and monuments. Third one, written material. And the fourth one, oral sources. First, we will study about coins. What we learn from coins, or what information can coins provide us to know history of a particular time or period. Children, this is a coin. Now, you may not see it clearly what is written there, but if you take any coin that you have now, maybe you can get it from your daddy. Get one coin. Okay. You can see as it is here, national emblem of India. Turn the coin. You will see the value of the coin. Then you can see languages are used. Here, Hindi and English is used. Then at the bottom of every coin, will find date. So from this one coin we can get different information. What a coin can provide us with information? First, see name of ruler or king. If you take a coin of a medieval period, then definitely you will see a picture of the ruler or the king who ruled during that period when the coin was made. Then when he ruled, already I said, because the date will be mentioned in the coin, then we get the information what language was used. Now we also can get what type of metal was used to make the coin. It may be gold, maybe silver or copper, anything. By seeing a gold coin, definitely historians can tell us that that king or the ruler was very wealthy. Artifacts. I already told you what are artifacts. Artifacts are things made and used by earlier people. See, they could be household goods, jewelry. Children, look at the page 17. See, the study of such artifacts and of the buildings of early times is known as archaeology. So what is archaeology? Archaeology is the study of artifacts and buildings of the past or historical buildings. Now, who is called an archaeologist? Archaeologist, see, who is called an archaeologist? Archaeologist is an expert in archaeology. Archaeologists learn from these artifacts how people lived in earlier times. For example, a clay toy. Look at here. A clay toy given. A clay toy with wheels tells archaeologists that the people knew how to use clay to make toys. They can also guess that the people may have had vehicles with wheels. Very often, artifacts are buried underground. What do the archaeologists do? Archaeologists uncover them by digging very carefully. Why very carefully? If they are not careful, then those old remains of the past may get damaged. That is why they work very carefully. People have also left behind buildings which can still be seen. These historical buildings are called monuments. And I showed you different pictures of monuments. Here in your book, some pictures are given. Look at the monuments given in your book. I showed you Taj Mahal. Here also Taj Mahal given. This Taj Mahal was made by who? Yes, Shah Jahan. And this Taj Mahal gives us lot of information when we look at the decoration, because precious stones are used to decorate the walls of the Taj Mahal. And definitely this tells us that Shah Jahan was a very wealthy emperor. You might have heard about Pompeii. This is an ancient city in Italy which was destroyed by volcanic eruption of Mount Vesuvius in 1900 AD, and archaeologists dug the city and found the old Pompeii city. All of you have seen a picture of pyramids, and many of you have seen movie, English movie, The Mummy. It has got part 1, part 2. These pyramids of Egypt gives us lot of information about the lives of Egyptians. So children, today we learned different sources of history, but today we will stop here, and the rest we will learn in the next video. In the next video, we will learn about written records, that is another source of history. Today we have learned about coins, artifacts, monuments. Learn these subtopics. If you have any query or any doubt, you can write in the comment box and I will clarify your doubt. Thank you.